Hello and welcome to Sports United. This past week has provided a whole host of sporting triumphs. Don't worry if you missed all the action, because we're about to bring you up to speed from the four corners of the globe. Here's a little taster of what's to come. The Cricket World Cup is off and running down under. The Rally Boys are back in action for round two in Sweden. And we fly into the ski jumping history books in Norway. Australia and New Zealand are jointly hosting the 11th edition of the Cricket World Cup. Among the match day one results, Australia thrashed England, New Zealand knocked Sri Lanka for six, while Ireland shocked the West Indies. But a record 1 billion people tuned in to see two of the sport's fiercest rivals lock horns in Adelaide when defending champs India took on neighbours Pakistan in their Pool B opener. It doesn't get much bigger than this, India v Pakistan. Having won their previous five World Cup encounters against their rivals, defending champions India proved again stiff opposition from the crease as they batted first. Thanks to fine innings from Shikhar Dhawan, Suresh Raina and Virat Kohli, India took the game away from Pakistan. Virat Kohli thrilled the crowds when he reached the 100 mark. He eventually finished on 107 as the holders set a chasing target of 300 for 7. Pakistan had 50 overs to reach 301 for the win, but their chase was jittery and error-riddled. Having shined with the bat earlier, Virat's equally solid hands in the outfield didn't help Pakistan's cause either. A fine stand by Pakistan captain Misbah-ul-Haq wasn't enough to hold up the rest of his teammates, who eventually collapsed, 76 runs short of their target. It left India celebrating their sixth consecutive World Cup win against their rivals and an ideal start to their title defence.
Sebastien Ogier began the defence of his World Rally Championship title by winning the season opener in Monte Carlo. Round two took place in the snowy forests of central Sweden. And what a thriller that turned out to be.
It went to the wire in an exhilarating second leg. VW's Ogier was in a very tight three-way battle for the win with teammate Andreas Mikkelsen and Thierry Neuville with only a 15-kilometre special left. When leader Mikkelsen made a costly error, Ogier's flawless drive proved enough to overturn a three-second deficit to take victory ahead of Neuville with Mikkelsen in third. Ogier becomes the first non-Scandinavian to win the event twice whilst maintaining his perfect start to the season.
With rugby appearing at the Rio Olympics in 2016, the annual Rugby Sevens World Series has added importance this year as it offers Olympic qualification spots. After Australia, Dubai, South Africa and New Zealand, the 16th running of the series touched down in Las Vegas for the fifth of nine stops.
Fiji reached the final of Las Vegas, having brushed aside all who stood in their way. It was no different against New Zealand in the showpiece match. The talented Pacific Islanders enjoyed a 35-19 victory for the second success after round one in Australia. Fiji are third in the standings now, only 2 points behind New Zealand, but 7 points off leaders South Africa. The top four out of the 15 core teams at the end of the season qualify for the Olympics. The sixth stop is in Hong Kong at the end of March.
It's been a record-breaking period in the world of ski jumping. Slovenia's Peter Prevec set a world mark of 250 metres at Vikersund in Norway, but that honour only lasted 24 hours, much to the delight of the home crowd.
There's nothing like setting a record, apart from doing it on home snow. That's exactly what 23-year-old Norwegian Anders Fannemel did whilst competing in a World Cup event, and this is how he did it. His stunning effort of 251.5 metres landed him firmly in the record books only one day after they had been rewritten by Prevec.
Table tennis is almost considered a religion in China, a country that has dominated the sport for decades. This week, we shine our spotlight on the creme de la creme of the female game in China and the world.
I'm Ding Ding. I'm from China. For Ning Ding, table tennis began at the age of six. Unable to sit still whilst waiting for her mother to finish coaching a local basketball team, she picked up a paddle and started to play in the room above. It was the beginning of a very successful relationship. Now 24, she is already a world champion, a two-time World Cup champion, an Olympic team gold medalist, and Asian champion. The left-hander, nicknamed Big Baby, has now reached the dizzying heights of the world number one ranking, and in 2014 was voted Female Player of the Year. The only thing missing from her impressive list of achievements is Olympic singles gold. Watch out for Rio 2016.
Being alone at the top of the world is something Kilian Jornet is very used to. Aside from being the best trail runner on the planet, he's also at the leading edge of the emerging discipline of ski mountaineering. The 27-year-old Catalan and world number one explains what this leg-burning, lung-busting sport is all about.
It's going up to a summit, going down off piste. Team races, it's races by teams of two or three persons around 3,000 to 4,000 meters elevation, going up and going down in really technical mountains. The individual race, it's the same, like three or four uphills in different mountains, only by yourself. Then is the vertical race, that it's only uphill race around between 600 and 1,000 meters of elevation. And then is the sprint, that is a really short race. It's about 3 minutes with an uphill, a transition with walking part and a downhill. We use the same gear as alpine ski, but really, really light. The binding, you have the possibility to go up, so it's like a cross-country ski binding, but in the downhill you can lock, so you go like alpine ski. In the uphills we put a skin, we glue a skin in the ski to keep the ski in the uphill, and we take off for going down.
Coming up next week, we take to the tatami with the world's best judokas looking to make their mark on the new season. And we see what it's like to be a gladiator on a bike on ice.
We've come to the end of the show, but before we go, check out our emotion of the week, which comes from the grand final of the Snow Polo World Cup in China. 17,000 kilometres away from their sun-drenched home, Brazil brought the heat to the snow-capped field of Tianjin and beat the USA to lift their maiden title. From all the Sports United team here, thanks for watching, enjoy the clip, and see you next week.
It's all over. 11-5 to Brazil. They win the 2015 Snow Polo World Cup.